sparks in a tiny angels running round in joy. Together pave the path, they can ride on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Behind Sparks, making the album, the Ricky Paquette album that came out in November 2021, a very special year, that is. And one of the things that made it very special is that I got to make some music with a very cool dude. And he's here with us for this episode talking about drinking beer and driving around. You'll get to know why he's here for this episode in about a few seconds. But let me introduce to you my new friend, Gordie Johnson from Big Sugar. Gordie, hey, how are you doing, man?
Good, man.
Good to see you.
Just through the magic of technology, like the way we made the record.
True enough. I know. How crazy is that?
We've actually never been in the same room before. We came really close in December, but it didn't happen.
Yeah, so I guess the stars weren't aligned yet. Hopefully they'll align themselves so that could happen in the near future. But for now,
I hate to spoil a good thing, though. I mean, I kind of like you long distance, and we did some really great work, man. For dudes who've never spent any time in a room together, it is kind of shocking how intimate and connected the record is. Between the two of us, I mean, we kind of created it. Well, we had a little bit of help from Anders Drerup, did a little bit of stuff for us. We had, you know, I brought my wife and kids in here for some gang vocals. I know you did something similar on your end. But other than that, it's just two guys and FaceTime making a record with Dropbox and WeTransfer and Google Drive.
Pro Tools and... Well, for today's episode, I would like for us to talk about our duet. We winded up making a duet on this record. And, well, that came to be in a very strange way. We were working, if I recall right, we were working on some riffs and on some music. And one late night, you send me some tracks. I had given you some guitars. I'm not exactly sure how it all went. We did the record like... in several months, so I can't remember how this particular song came to be, but
we were working on a completely other song, I seem to recall.
Right.
You had a song, we redid some lyrics, we were acoustic guitar back and forth, I put down some funky drums, a couple of riffs, and it was just sort of not really, it was just
we were calling it like Hot Planet or
Hot Minute, Lost whatever Planet. It was just not. It was just okay. It wasn't up to our usual standard. And I don't know if it was related, unrelated, but we just got to talking and bullshitting and telling stories. And my wife, I think it was my wife or my daughter, said, well, what you need to do is write a, like if it's a country record, you need to write just a good old boy redneck song. I'm like, yeah, okay, but, you know, as songwriters, we need to be more specific. And one of them said, well, just, I don't know, make it about drinking beer and driving around, you know? That's what every redneck wants to do. I'm like, wait a minute. And just the title alone, you suddenly confess this entire saga of you and your guitar tech on a bender in a farmhouse and running out of beer and getting on a tractor to go get some more beer. And I was like, what? Wait a sec. Let me grab a pencil.
I remember. That's coming back. Yeah, that's how it went. You said, I think you played the track and then someone said, well, this song, like you asked them, what do you think this song should be talking about? Like lyric-wise, you know, because we were a bit in a bit of a jam and that's it. You came back and said, my wife or my daughter, I'm not exactly sure who, said, they said, but this sounds like drinking beer and driving around. And then that's when I went and I told you the whole story about me and Flitin, Daniel, brother Daniel. Hell of a story. A true one. We embellished it somewhat or made it worse. I don't know. It depends from which angle you look at things.
It was already, there was already lots of humor in the reality of it. It was just putting it in the form of a song. So what a great way to collaborate, because it was like my, you know, when my wife was doing the paperwork, later, she's like, well, so like, so did Ricky write the verses or did you write the chorus? And I was like, no, Ricky lived it. Ricky lived this. This is, you can't come up with this.
Yeah, so late night stories after like dinner, we shared some like pasta recipes, and I think our best time to do this music. I mean, you know, the music is pretty self-explanatory. You can't be singing and making music like this at 10 a.m. in the morning. I mean, you can, but we've tried, and most of our best stuff came out to be like after dinner.
The one nice thing about doing the record this way, there were no 12-hour days. Like, there were no 12, 15-hour, long, intense recording studio days. We were really able to do it, you know, like, take a break, make dinner, drink a coffee with my wife, come down, work for 2 hours with you on FaceTime, record some stuff, send it the next morning, wake up, oh, look, Ricky sent me some guitar parts, put that on. Like, it was a very low impact way of making a record. And I think you can hear that too. It sounds, no one sounds like they were under duress at any point, you know?
True enough, yeah. Well, I figured since we can't really jam together in the same room and we haven't had the chance to do that yet, maybe we could try and do that through the magic of technology, through FaceTime. I know you've played Drinkin Beer and Drivin' Around on your last acoustic tour, and it turned out to be a hit on that tour. So I'm just curious to hear you do that, like that song as a sitting down with the acoustic or something.
Well, you know, I was recently in New York City,
and here goes the story.
Here we go. I was in New York City. We were at a dinner, and there was some other notable artist. There was a sculptor and just, you know, people who are very accomplished in their respective fields of interest. And we'd had lots of wine, of course. There was lots of laughing and talking and sitting around. And the host of the party at one point thrust guitars into people's hands and were like, you gotta sing us a song. Gordy's amazing. You gotta hear Gordy. You gotta hear this guy sing. GJ, you gotta sing us a song. I was like, oh my God, this is not a concert. Nobody's ready for this. This is someone's kitchen, you know? And I thought, well, what do I have that's a big crowd pleaser? Guess what?
Oh, yeah.
Drinking beer and driving around. I could hardly get through it. Like, I had to stop so many times for people laughing. And even just the title of it, it's so audaciously naughty. It's just the most forbidden thing you can think of now. Oh dear.
I think it gets people's attention pretty quick. It's like, which song? Drinking beer and driving around.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
the line that gets the biggest laugh in the song is verse 2. You know, 15 miles an hour, we won't get very far. And I'll tell you all why. And as soon as I say, I cranked up the Kubota to go and get some more people. Yeah. Right at that point, I got to put a little stop in there because.
Yeah. Pause it. Well, in a song like this, I think pauses really, they enhance the story. When you pause and you look and you give that little fraction of a second for people to realize what just happened and what was just said or sung, and then you're there.
Yeah. Pretty funny. Yeah, it's been very rewarding to add it to my repertoire. I hope you don't mind. I think it's now a concert staple. I don't see how I can do a show without it.
Well, man, it's my honor. I mean, it's just, I think it's a great tune. And to hear you sing it, it's just, it's like, for me, it's a bonus. It just feels like, yeah, man, that's a true story. Yeah. and it's about me.
I look forward to singing it in some honky-tonk setting here in Texas at some point. Once I get back out and playing gigs again here, I have a feeling.
Well, how about you play it for us in not a honky-tonk, but from the Gordie Johnson Sound Shack, directly from Austin, Texas.
Yeah, man. Drinking beer and driving around.
Let's do it.
Down on the farm, you make your own fun. Horsing around and shooting guns. Me and brother Daniel weren't hurting anyone. But Daniel turned to me and said,
"Now fear me, son.
I'm hearty for the party. You don't have to twist my arm. Beer's a no-brainer. Works like a charm.
Sometimes."
Me and brother Daniel, we drank 24. We were powerful thirsty, so we lit out the door. Now we're drinking beer and driving around. We can't take the truck and we can't take the car, 'cause we're drinking beer and driving around. 15 miles an hour, we won't get very far. Tell you why. We cranked up my Kubota to go and get some more. Now we're shit-faced and shirtless at the party store. The beer was in the cooler, but the missus was colder. That's when Daniel told her, "Get a load of that Kubota. We ain't drunk, we're just drinking. So forget what you're thinking. If we get too high, we'll drive on the shoulder." When we're drinking beer and driving around,
can't take the truck, can't take the car.
Drinking beer and driving around,
in a 50 miles an hour, we won't get very far.
We're drinking beer and driving around. Two little rednecks, shit out of luck. We got to ditch a reefer and toss all the cans. Step on it, Daniel, 'cause here comes the main gang. The cops, Johnny Law, the highwayman, the popo, the fuzz, the heat. Les gendarmes de Quebec, sometimes you win, sometimes you're a loser. Two pickled peppers in the back of the cruiser. They took away my tractor and threw us in a can. Hey, Daniel,
say,
how are we gonna tell our old man that we were drinking beer and driving around?
Can't take the car, can't take the truck.
Well, we're drinking beer and driving around.
Stuff,
yeah, Ricky.
So we lit out the door and now we're
drinking beer and driving around. But we can't take the truck, can't take the car, because we're drinking beer and driving around. Yeah. And I'm 15 miles an hour.
If you like what you've heard and you want to hear more, head on over to your favorite digital platform and stream my new album, Sparks. Thanks for tuning in, and I hope I get to rock on a stage near you very soon, wherever you are.